In this video, we're going to look at signing into the NHS app. So if you locate the NHS app on your phone, you just tap on it and that will open it up. And then at the bottom where it says continue with NHS login, if you tap on there, then you'll need to enter the email address. So first of all, if you've not been on it for a while, or you may have set it up during COVID and you're not sure if you've got an NHS login, if you just pop your email address in and it will tell you whether you have one or not. So start typing it in. If you've typed in your email address before on your phone, it will usually pop up along the bottom on here. If it does, just tap on it and it will populate that field for you. And then all we need to do is tap continue. If you have an NHS login, it will tell you on the screen here, it says, so I have one, so it says, we have found your NHS login. So tap continue and you'll need to pop in your password. You can tap show if you just want to double check to see if you put it in right. If you're not sure, type in the password that you think it might be and then tap continue. It will then send a 6-digit security code to the mobile phone. So that usually should be the one that you're on. When it arrives, pop the code in. It'll either maybe pop across on the banner on the top of your screen, or if it has arrived and you tap in the box to bring up the number keypad, there may be a way I've done there, give you the option just to copy and paste it direct from your message. If it's the device that you normally use, if you tap the box there and the next time you sign in, it won't ask you for a security code. Once you put your email address and password in, you'll be logged in. So we'll tap continue. If it's been a while, sometimes there's been updates on terms and conditions, anything like that. You'll need to agree and continue if you want to continue onto the app. So we'll tap agree and continue. And then here we've got the option on turn on notifications. So it's quite useful to get notifications from the NHS app. There might be things regarding test results or appointments, or any messages from the NHS that might be important. If you'd like to receive them, tap yes or no if you'd rather not. That would require you to check the NHS app to see if there's been any updates. Whereas if you turn on the notifications, you will be notified of any updates to the NHS app or to your account, and then we'll give you the option to open up the NHS app to have a look at those. Whichever you decide, tap on it and then tap continue at the bottom. Sometimes there'll be additional window that pops up just to allow access on your phone. This is usually to do with the permissions on your phone. It's just making sure that you're happy to allow the NHS app to send you notifications. So just tap allow. If you've got any additional security, so fingerprint or face ID, you can set this up now. You can always do it later if you're not sure. But this makes it a lot easier to get in, so you can either, the next time you log in, you'll either use your face or fingerprint ID to log you in rather than your password. So if you're not very good at remembering passwords, this is quite useful. So you can choose here yes or no, so we're going to choose yes. And then there's an additional notification, so that's just again affecting the permissions on your phone with the NHS app. So just tap OK. We usually then check the face ID. So if you're looking at the phone, it will just check to make sure that it is you and it matches the face ID on the phone. Or if it's the fingerprint, it will ask you to pop your fingerprint in to make sure that it is the fingerprint that is registered on the phone for the security. Once you're in, this is the home screen. So have your name, date of birth and NHS number across the top. A list of popular services on the main screen. And you'll notice along the bottom, you've got an additional menu. So there's advice, appointments, prescriptions, your health and messages. If you tap on any one of those, it will open them up. And that is how to sign in to the NHS app if you have an existing NHS account. Thanks for watching.